NGO leaders, dignitaries on the dais. Well, that is a pretty heavy compendium of best practices. Thank you so much. I'm sure these have been validated and these will be of great use. Three things I will like to say about any event which we do for best practices. One, scalability. Second, sustainability. And third is outcome oriented. So I'm sure I'll go through this, whether their outcomes are also listed of what happened before and after these things. But you know, like pilots, I always say that, you know, most of the pilots which we do never fly. So I'm a bit skeptical about best practices happening for so long in India and still we are, you know, again talking about best practices. So where is the gap? Is the gap coming across the table? Is the gap between NGOs and the government? Is a gap between the NGOs and the administration? So let's bridge that gap. That's the most important thing. I'm sure these best practices in the maternal and child health, some of them would be definitely replicable. Some of them should be immediately replicable. Some of them must be very low-hanging fruits which are happening. Like if you're talking about maternal child health, you know, the most common thing which comes to my mind is when we have nearly about 80% institutional deliveries, still in the first hour, breastfeeding by mother is only 42%. Why? Where are we lacking? This is perhaps the easiest thing which we have not been able to do. So I have a proposal here. We in Niti have a portal called Knowledge Portal, which will be soon unveiling. We will like to put all these validated case studies on the portal, which can be seen by each everyone, including the research institutes, the district collectors. So now we have you must be aware of the project called Aspirational Districts Project by the Prime Minister. Those backward districts, 101 backward districts, there's a huge emphasis for their development, which Niti is spearheading. I will in fact request NGOs who are working on in the field. Those 101 districts are available on the website. If you want, I can share them. Please come forward and help us in transforming these districts. Because if these districts get transformed, India gets transformed. These are those 101 backward districts. We don't use the word backward. We call them as aspirational districts. Those districts now which need to come forward. And we are determined that by 2022, these districts will be in the mainstream and perhaps leading those districts. In fact, Prime Minister will be shortly visiting one of these districts on 14th of April, which he had promised in the presentation which the collectors had made him last time on this aspirational districts. Coming to the new initiative of Ayushman Bharat, now this is a historic landmark mission which the government has embarked upon. Perhaps in less than 2 months, the whole scheme was approved by the cabinet once it was announced. One of the shortest gap you can see. So the seriousness, yesterday a CEO has been also appointed. If you have read through the newspapers, he's an ex-administrator and was a vice president of ADB Southeast Asia. So the government is very serious about this. This scheme has certain great features which we have learned from RSPY experiences of state schemes, the best practices being implemented in the whole world about health protection. One of them is this is an entitlement-based scheme. You don't have enrollment here like the other previous schemes, like somebody, you have to go somewhere and show your identity and say, look, I am this, and then you get enrolled in the scheme. In this scheme, it's an entitlement based on SECC, and once you reach a point of care, if you are in the list, you will get the treatment. So the challenge will be the informing the beneficiary of whether they're entitled or not. So it's about 40% of the whole country is covered, roughly about 10.74 crore families. Or nearly about 50 crore individuals. On 30th of April, we are having a Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. All the Gram Sabhas in the country will be commemorating an Ayushman Divas, Ayushman Bharat Divas. And in every Gram Sabha, the eligible list will be read out. And we will be also collecting some additional data of ration cards or phone numbers, or if there has been any change in the number of family members for each family. So 30th April, I'll request each of the NGOs who are there to please come forward and participate in the Gram Panchayat on the Panchayat Bhavan, where it will be like a munadi. We will be sharing the list, putting it on the Gram Sabha, and also telling the individuals about this scheme. Secondly, and most importantly, I will also request all of you to handhold and inform people about the benefits. You know what happens? See, I have worked in state of Kerala, though I'm a doctor from Chandigarh. What the best part in Kerala and why Kerala did so better in health services was the literacy and the felt need of the people, the demand for good services, which perhaps is lacking in North India. North India grapples with something I normally say is the unmet need. You know, many people say that out-of-pocket expenditure has not gone down, even the scheme has been launched, because out-of-pocket expenditure does not cover your unmet needs. Have you heard of people in rural areas talking about angioplasty or angiography or even a knee replacement? No. Either they are not aware or they have given up. Now, this mission says 5 lakhs per individual family, targeted to those families actually who have unmet needs. Go to any of the public and private hospitals, take treatment cashless, paperless, free of cost, and in best hospitals they can go, whatever are getting empaneled by the states. So it's empowerment, it's a freedom of choice to the individual, rather than just saying that you are only going to the public health hospitals, though in theory and paper all public health hospitals are free of cost, but we know it had overriding costs attached to it. Now, for this scheme, there should be no costs attached for this mission. We'll have a helpline number where people can even lodge their feedback, suggestions, advice, or grievances. So my request to all the NGO leaders who are present here, please get associated with us. We will look forward for your support, for your guidance, for your mentorship, especially in the field, at the Gram Sabha level, at the Asha A&M level, at the Anganwadi level. If we can tell them more about this scheme, I will be happy to partner with FICCI, and if through you we can send this message across to the whole country about this 30th event also, we will be very happy to share more details of the scheme. Anyone more interested, please walk in. My room number is 303D in Nirman Bhavan, and you don't have to take appointment. On board outside it is just walk in. So if you are there, please come and we will share more details with you. We will be soon hosting our website and putting on more details about the scheme as and when they get approved. Looking forward for your support. And since I also handled in Niti the voluntary action cell, I hope each one of you NGOs have a unique ID which the Niti Aayog is doing. If you have any hassles or any difficulties, just let me know also, because in future that will become a unique identifier for each of the schemes which you will be working for, or for any of the payments being released to you. Thank you so much.